Let me ask you all one question. How many of you love to talk? Okay, out of all those who have raised their hands, how many of you believe how well you communicate depends upon how well you can talk? Even I believe so. I love to talk a lot, no matter be it any situation or be with anyone. I used to keep talking and talking. But the people with whom I used to talk had to offer to me a different lesson altogether. It's gradually, I started losing connect with my friends and family members. At my workplace, I was not at all considered an effective manager. Even the girl who I used to like decided to desert me. Completely disheartened, I went to my mentor and I asked him, "Sir, you know, I'm such a confident person. I love to talk a lot to people, but I don't know why I'm not able to maintain good relationship with them." My mentor told me that something which really made me think about myself. He asked me, "Varun, are you listening? Toastmaster of the day, dear guests, members, and all those who love to talk." My mentor told me, "Varun, if you would have been a good communicator, then you would have listened more to understand rather than just keep talking. Listening is one of the most important skills you can have. How well you listen has got a major impact on your job effectiveness, as well as the quality of relationship with people." So after knowing this, there began my research on listening skill. A research by International Listening Association shows that almost 66% in our professional life are not satisfied with their job, out of which almost 46% of the time people fail to succeed because of poor listening. Poor listening leads to misunderstanding, which in turn leads to ineffective decision making, thereby resulting into costly mistakes. There are negative impacts of poor listening even on our personal relationships too. Almost 72% couples break up due to incompatibility, and out of which almost 57% of the time the reason is poor listening. So when I got to know how major impact does listening has on our life, I went further ahead to understand how much do we really listen. So a study by Wharton says that almost in average a person listens with 25% efficiency. So no matter you guys over here are hearing my speech for 7 minutes, believe me, you are listening to me properly for less than 2 minutes. Because the rest of the 75% of the time our mind is preoccupied with something or distracted. So immediately when you listen to someone, you are able to remember the 50% of what other person has said. So you might be wondering, all the married couples, no matter they keep talking to each other the entire day, or no matter keep fighting with each other the entire day, but still they remember the half of the day's talks. And then they blame the partner does not listen to them or understand them. This is the reason, right? You would be surprised to know this. We almost listen at a rate of 125 to 250 words per minute. But we think almost 1000 to 3000 words per minute. Our mind definitely wins the race in thinking compared to listening. This really made me curious to know why are we such a poor listener. So what I did was I conducted a small survey with 25 Toastmaster members to find out what are the 3 key reasons why are we such a poor listener. So the first reason is our mind. We think a lot, you see. We think more than we listen. Right now, some of the people over here may be thinking about their plans ahead for Sunday evening. Sanjeev would be thinking when and how will be his next speech. Kriti will be thinking, when will this speech get over? I'm so wet, I'm hungry, I want to eat. The second reason is sense of importance. We all, consciously or subconsciously, we want to feel important. And this sense of importance goes high when we are meeting somebody for the first time. Like when I used to meet someone for the first time, I used to make it sure that I make my first impression the best impression. So I used to end up talking a lot about myself, blowing my own trumpet, and the result of which I used to end up talking. The third reason is we knowingly or unknowingly are judgmental. We judge other people based on our past experience and assume what other person is going to say. Thereby, we just listen to give them a reply. So now, after knowing the problem, you might be wondering, what is the solution? How we can improve our listening? So here is a three-step solution for active listening. The first step is, consider the other person, the host of your conversation. Like how you see a TV host and you being an audience, listen to him completely. The second step is, give 100% attention by maintaining proper eye contact as well as using verbal cues when required. Verbal cues, like something you don't understand, then repeat what the other person must have said. The third and the final step is, respect the other person. No matter what be the situation, don't be judgmental and keep your open mind. Listen to what the other person has to say. When I completed this research, I realized my mistake. And now, I listen more than I talk. As Stephen Covey has said, in this generation of technology, the communication is still failing. Because we want to listen just to talk and not to understand. So my friends, the next time you want to talk to someone, ask this simple question to yourself. Are you listening?
Thank you, Varun. A minute silence, a minute for the evaluators.